Welcome back, everyone. I'm Jay Barino, and this is Starcraft Mass Recall, a Starcraft Brood War remake in Starcraft 2. In the last mission, we cheesed it a little bit. We built like 25 to 30 wraiths, and we flew around the edge of the map to kill the command center. Kind of fun. Maybe I should have waited and used that strategy this mission. I don't know. We'll see how tough this is. I've seen some people on the forums talking about how this one and the last mission are pretty rough. And it wasn't on the forums. It was comments on my own videos. So we'll see how this goes.
Captain, we have tracked the fugitives Minx and Raynor to the devastated Protoss homeworld of Ire. Apparently, these two have taken shelter within a fortified Protoss encampment that lies at the base of a fully functional warp gate.
I don't understand this. Why would the Protoss harbor these men?
I have no idea, Gerard, but the Protoss aren't our only problem. Our sensors have identified multiple Zerg broods surrounding the Protoss base. Presently, the broods seem to be passive, but there's no telling what might set them off. Should the broods attack, we'd be hard-pressed to hold them at bay.
I see. It is a risk we will need to take. Minx represents a considerable threat to our agenda and must be eliminated. Captain? You will focus your attack against the Rebel Command Center in the middle of the Protoss encampment. That must be where Minx and Raynor are hiding. We will deploy our own Valkyrie frigates and tighten up our air defenses. Vice Admiral Stukov and Lieutenant Durant will provide cover for your forces and ensure that no external threats interfere with your mission.
Cool, so we're going to be fighting Zerg and Protoss this mission. They're like, oh, the Zerg might not attack you. Yeah, yes, they will. Let's be honest here. What an excellent opening cinematic. That's why everything about this mod is just awesome. It's just so good. Okay, so let's get mining. We actually need... we need like 5 depots, I think. Yeah, 49 supplies. So let's get started. Then once those are done, we'll send them all up to mine. So let's go ahead and land my barracks. This guy's landed, and we'll land my... factory. That was such a cool intro. And the music's still going. I don't even mind. Okay, so let's get these tanks off this ledge, and the reason that I'm going to do that is because I don't like having them up here. They don't do extra damage for being up there. They take less. There's a 30% mischance up the ramp road thing, but I would rather keep them alive because they're completely open to air attacks, and the Zerg send a bunch of air attacks at you this mission, if I recall correctly. So, more depots? Seriously? Alright, we'll make 6. Okay, so once this creep's cleared up, we'll make bunkers. We're gonna start lining our tanks up here. Okay, and the normal music is back. But that was a fun good time. That was a good time for everybody. Alright. So we're just going to queue up a ton of SCVs, because we want some mineral production. Now, this mission is difficult for several reasons. One, there's a nice base to take here, just to the northwest, but it is directly connected to a Zerg base. So you're just going to get attacked constantly by the Zerg if you take it. Further, if you take the... So I would think, okay, well then take that Zerg base out entirely. But if you do that, then the Protoss are more likely to attack you because they have one less Zerg person they need to kill. So it's just kind of a mess all around. Makes it pretty difficult to decide who to be attacking. I think what I'm going to do this mission is just turtle up, similar to what I did last mission. Now, there's not a lot of minerals here, so I have to be very careful, but I don't feel confident that I could keep another base. So what I'm going to do is just mine the shit out of this, max out a 200-200 army, push on the Protoss, and hope to God that I win, because if I lose my units then it's all over. Like, immediate loss. So, but I think that's how I'm going to play it. Luckily, they give us two science vessels, which have everything researched already. That's awesome. That is excellent. Okay. So with that, I assume that means there will be lurkers this mission. So... that's nice of them to give us that amount of science vessels. And then I can irradiate, too. Irradiate's going to be real helpful against defending against the Zerg. So, what happens is Mutalisks come over here, and Mutalisks come over here. At least that's what they used to do. So, what I'm going to go ahead and do is keep my Valkyries over in this direction, because... And I'm going to start repairing them. Depots again, seriously. Reason being is I want to... Can I get this SCV out of here? No, don't be in the bunker. Okay, get back to mining. Because over here I have bunkers, I'm less concerned, and I have a turret too. So I'm less concerned about not having ground defense or air defense. So over here, though, I'll just keep the Valkyries and everything will be fine. Come on! I'm shocked. The Zerg that were supposedly docile are going to come and attack us. I'm going to go ahead and get some turrets here too, because I don't want my Valkyries dying. So I have to decide how I want to play this, like, right now. I think I'm going to get a bunch of tanks, because those tanks will also be used in my attacking force. Now, eventually, I want to have, like, 20 tanks just smashed up here, keep 10 of them at home, and take the other 10 with me to attack the Protoss. So if I can do that, I do see a carrier here. Jesus. All right, so we're going to need some pretty much a strong Goliath Marine Medic force. And I think that's how I'm going to play this. So with luck, nothing will go terribly wrong. So let's start our tanks. And I also would really like to get a second factory. If I can be producing off like 3 factories eventually, but I can't really afford it right now. So again, the goal is to survive until I can mine out all of these minerals, and then depending on what I can build with those minerals, hopefully we can win. Hopefully. Okay, and then we want to do our standard supply depot thing where only a certain amount of units will be able to get through. Now, something in the future I could do is just build, like, a giant, like, supply depot wall. Like, an enormous one. I don't know if that's something that would be worth doing. Also, those supply depots will die, so I need to make sure I make redundant ones in the back. Really want that armory so I can start Goliaths, too. Goliaths will be very, very helpful. I want to be using my... I have to make sure I'm using my science vessel so that I can defense matrix in troubled tanks. That'll be very helpful in attacking. EMP, it takes away all the shields. All of them. Whereas, like, Ghosts in Starcraft 2, they only take away some. No. We're going to take all the shields, because we're assholes in Brood War. So that'll be really helpful to defend, too. Also, it will, we can use it against High Templar. It'll take away all their energy. Or most of it. I don't know. So that's cool. Keep making tanks. Basically, we're just going to make tanks to defend, and they'll also be there to... attack when we're ready, and then we'll slowly build up kind of a reserve force of Goliaths in the back. And if we can manage to not get supply block through all of it, I'll consider it a success. So we'll start our vehicle weapons. No enemy attacks yet. That's scary. Here they come. Any tanks getting attacked? No. Bunker. Can we save the bunker? Yes, we can. So they are sending lurkers at us. That's going to get annoying. We'll go ahead and seize you right there. And can we get out? Yes. Alright, we have a probably more than enough SCVs. Let's go ahead and get my second and third factories. Maybe there, and over here. I hear Mutalisks. Yes, I did not build those missile turrets for no reason. Oh, so good. Screw you, Mutalisks. All right, and now I only have to repair the missile turrets and not the Valkyries. So it's little things like that that save you money in the long term, especially on missions like this, where money is a problem. And money is certainly a problem. So we do want to get an academy. And let's go ahead and get our plus one weapons as well. That will help our guys in the bunkers to not die. Kill things faster. Therefore, if the faster they can kill things, the less things are attacking them, the bunkers will stay alive, yada, yada, yada. So, feeling real good about these science vessels. If I can just not lose them, if I can be using their abilities offensively, specifically EMP, we can really go places this mission. So, that's my goal. Valkyries, you're still going to kind of stay over here to make sure things are going well. It feels strange doing this without taking another expansion, because I want to. I need one. I need another expansion, but I just can't do it. The only one is really this upper left one, and I just can't defend it. Let's get those Charon boosters. Those will be real helpful. And let's get two tanks and a Goliath. And Goliath, you're just going to hang back here. You'll be helpful later. So Valkyries, they do... Whoa, okay. They do 3 versus small, and 4 point... I always thought it went backwards. I thought they did the most against small and did less against large. That would imply that Valkyries do a significant amount of damage against things like Guardians. So that's good. That's really good. I would not have expected that. More tanks and Goliath. So we'll do 2 tanks Goliath, and then eventually we'll start switching the ratio. Until I feel more comfortable about it. We can get a medic, just so we have a medic. And we'll get vehicle plating, and let's get a science facility so that we can get those upgrades a little higher. Now, we are running low on space. I'm concerned if I build over here that the Protoss or the Zerg will attack it. And I'd really prefer if that was not the case. Okay, you are stuck, but what I can do is pick you up with a dropship and get you out of there. Like, I don't even want to build extra marines at this point. Alright, SCVs, come and repair. Whoa, I see guardians. Oh, that's a lot of guardians. Kill them! Valkyries, this is your time to shine. Get out of there. Okay, well, I lost all the marines in that, but that's not really a big deal, is it? Okay. So, repair that. We got... Oh, I see Protoss. EMP. Ha! Ooh, and I got the High Templar! He can't storm me! You're the worst. Protoss, you're the worst. Alright, Marines, come on over and you're gonna kill that High Templar because he's an asshole. Let's rebuild my bunker. Oh no, Marines! What a mistake! Okay, we need to kill these Mutalisks with my Valkyries. And we need to make more Goliaths. Now it's Goliath time. So I just queued up a ton. Like, I shouldn't be able to queue up that much stuff at once, but I did it! Let's see. Okay, you guys are cool. You're cool. Real cool. Now, unfortunately, I lost my medic, so we'll remake her. We'll make another medic. And bunkers. We need bunkers again. Bunker. Bunker. And we're going to set all you to auto-repair. Well, I could say that went way better than I could have hoped for. You know what? I really need a commsat station, too. That's going to be just invaluable. You know, let's get a second armory, too. That way we can research 2-2 simultaneously, if I can. I don't know if I can afford it. I queued up way too many Goliaths at once. Let me guess. There's another lurker up there. There is. Can I get to it? Alright, I'm gonna scooch some of these tanks up, because they are not close enough. Get in there. You three are gonna head up here. And I am in range of that asshole, so... You guys get in here. And the rest of you get in there. Not you, medic. Okay, feeling good. I got a lot of tanks. And I've got a lot of, a decent amount of Goliaths. I did get the Charon boosters, didn't I? Okay. There's another depot. And we'll make another depot there, too. Scary. Okay, so... There's not a lot of room, and basically, if they break through this one choke point, I'm dead. So, I don't know. It's a little frightening, because I'm banking everything on this strategy, and if it doesn't work... well, then it doesn't work. I guess it just... That's the way things go. So, I need 250, or 350 gas and minerals in order to get both of these. I don't know if it's worth... Oh, get back. No problem. This amount of tanks, what are they really going to do? We want to get sight because there's more. Okay, and then you three tanks, are going to siege over in this direction. Yeah, get through. Okay. Unsiege... You and you. Oh, Lord. Oh, God. Where's my vessels? Tank, what are you doing? I saved him! See that clutch save? Alright, you get over here. You get up here. That lurker is still there. You just come over here and wait, okay? Just chill out. We'll make a bunch of Goliaths. We'll make a bunch of Marines. Well, not a bunch, because I don't have that much... Alright, I think I have the tanks that I need. Let's go ahead and just get our plus 2 attack, at least. Even though we can't afford our plus 2, plus 2 armor. I'm feeling okay now. Again, it really depends on how much I'm going to leave at home. I'm doing okay on minerals. You can kind of catch the tip of the base that I would take if I was, if I wasn't so tentative about it, but I'm frightened about it. We've got more Protoss coming. Let's EMP these assholes. Oh, I see a Reaver! Reaver, kill him! Kill him! Tanks, yeah! Tanks outrange Reavers. Fucking jerks. So now we'll just go ahead and rebuild this bunker because my Marines that were in it didn't die. Which is actually a nice little treat for me. So for once. I'm feeling okay. How many tanks do I have? 1, 2, 3, 8, 12. How many do I really need to push out? Let's keep making them. I really want 10 tanks, and I want to be able to leave at least 6 here to defend. Because did you see how many Ultralisks Orange just sent against me? Stop sending those jerk Ultralisks waves at me, map makers. I know it's just a trolly thing that you're putting in there. You admitted it to me. But actually, it's pretty hilarious. Or that might just be part of the attacks. The attacks in this mission are not kidding. Okay, come over here. Come over here, Valkyries. You are going to get attacked first, probably. So, oh, yeah, clump up, Mutalisks. I think I'm just going to leave these Valkyries at home to defend. All right, more tanks. I can afford them. All right, with this... I want to finish my plus 2, and then I'm going. I'm definitely going. I can afford to make Marines, and I'll bring Marines, Goliaths with me, but then that's it. I can't wait too long, because then the attacks that will be sent at me will be so absurdly difficult to kill that I won't be... I have to pretty much push to win. Here comes blue, or brown. I see Mutalisks. My Goliaths, though, are pretty much holding down the fort. No problem. Okay, let's keep making Goliaths, and you be a tank, actually, and Marine medic. We are approaching the 150 realm, which is kind of what I was thinking would be the sweet spot. And then again, when I move out, I'm moving out. Like, that's it. So, what do I want to leave? We're going to take you guys. And we're going to take you. And we're going to take all of this. And I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 tanks at home. So once all this stuff gets out of here, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to queue up... How much is a science vessel? 225. I'm going to queue up an extra science vessel to keep at home. Protoss kind of just attacked me, and Zerg did just attack me, so... If I can't survive this, with this amount of stuff, then I don't deserve to win. Alrighty, so tanks, you're going to be 2. Let's bring a ton of SCVs with us, and by, like, a ton, I mean, like, 6. Let's set them to auto-repair. You're going to be 5. You're going to be 6. Okay, here we go. We're pushing straight through the warp gate. We're ignoring Zerg. Zerg won't attack us if we're attacking Protoss, I think. You guys get back. And we're making like a suicide attack up this ramp. Let's see if we can get all my units up here before I do anything crazy. And siege! Here we go! Alright, Goliath, target the carriers. Yes! So good! I need some stim. Stim? And... No, not that. I lost all my hotkeys for my buildings by doing this. So now the UED effectively controls the warp gate, let's make more tanks and keep them at home. Okay, here comes Brown. This is the moment of truth. If I can survive this, I'm okay. And I did. So come on up here so we can spot the lurkers. Okay, and bringing those SCVs was not a mistake. So let's keep going. Siege! Siege! What do we got? Okay, those were just the Mutalisks, the standard Mutalisk timing attack. Don't lose these tanks. I really need them to survive. Oh, no, the storm! Don't walk through it twice! Alright, SCVs, I need you. Hold position, everybody. Yes, the carriers don't spawn with interceptors, so I'm safe as they're building them here. Still safe at home. Make Marines. Make Goliaths. Keep them here. Alrighty, are we out of money yet? We still have some money at home, so we're able to... Whew. So we're able to keep repairing, basically. Alright, so here's the warp gate. Still invulnerable, but we control it. I don't know if anything ever comes of like the fact that the UED can control the warp gate. Alright, so let's just... Back out, back out, back out! Okay, what's getting attacked the most? This is okay, this is okay. And attack. Okay, we're scooching into the Protoss base now. We took out their stargates, which is, I think was the scariest part about them. Let's siege up here and hold position. I should have been EMPing the Archons. What am I doing? Alright, let's take out some of their production so they can't reinforce. I want you guys to come up to the warp gate and then rally up to my units because I don't want you running into this. Okay. So let's unsiege and scoot, keep scooting towards the command center. I think we're in good shape here. I don't know if this was the right choice for this mission. Again, I completely ignored attacking the Zerg and I don't regret that at all. Because I think I would have really screwed myself trying to hold on to extra bases that I couldn't. Right, you run. You run. Yeah. Mad Kitan right there. Okay. Oh, and we're at the command center. Cool. So let's do it. Brown's attacking me. We're diving this command center, though. Oh, God. Oh, God. That's a lot of Guardians, but I think we can kill them.
Good work, Captain. The command center is destroyed, but it looks like Minx and Raynor will try to escape through the warp gate. Make ready to move in and intercept their vessel before... Wait, I just picked up multiple search signals coming in from the northeast. That's Duran's position. He seems to have moved his forces out of place. Lieutenant Duran, this is Stuka. Come in. I'm tracking a massive Zerg swarm in your quadrant. Respond, dammit!
That is strange, Vice Admiral. My scanners don't show any Zerg at all. Maybe you have a technical problem with your equipment.
Lieutenant, if these Zerg get through, we'll never be able to capture Minsk. I'm giving you a direct order to return to your position and reinforce my troops.
Oh, I'm sorry, sir, but it seems your signal's fading out. I couldn't make out that last part. I'll try to re-establish contact later.
Duran! Captain, your position will be overrun by superior Zerg numbers within 15 minutes. I suggest you retreat back to the fleet immediately. Inform Admiral Dugal that I have a personal matter.
Use defense matrix. Where's the Valkyries? And so with that, I guess Raynor and Phoenix are now off Ire. This was what I was always confused about a little bit, was like, so they finally destroyed the warp gate on their end, they escaped with Mengsk, Raynor, or at least Raynor escaped with Mengsk. Does that mean, like, the Protoss resistance cell, the Kalai survivors on Ire, are now, like, gone? Because you don't really hear from them again until Enslaver's Dark Vengeance, I think. I don't think you go back to Ire at all. So, it's really not important, though, to the plot ongoing. I think we're just supposed to assume that they're gone now. Anyway, that was a challenging mission only because I had to do everything right, because if I failed that attack... But at the same time, I didn't even EMP my... I didn't even EMP as I was attacking, and things turned out fine. I got stormed directly on, and then walked right back through the storm, and, you know, everything went well. But always make sure you bring SCVs, always make sure you bring some medics, and build a shitload of tanks always. And that's how you win. Anyway, this has been Jay Barino. Appreciate you watching, and I will see you next time. Bye.